Helps. Pulls really hard, look, to get power into the backflip and lift into the somersault. Willing those legs around twice, almost lost it. Final tumble run. Double back somersault in the tucked position. Elena Doviana. There you can see the foot outside of the area.
The world champion waits. For the Czechoslovakian girl. Now what about Dobre? Came into the championship troubled by that left knee, which is well bandaged. Being slightly written off. Is she going to make a comeback with a good start on the floor? So far is yes.
Her best performance on the floor to date, starting only 0.5 behind Shushanova.
Much more her real self.
Interesting to note the number of twisting elements she did on what is a damaged knee. This line ended in a double tuck somersault backwards. No problem there. But knee injuries are nearly almost always caused by twisting into the floor, not managing to complete the twists before you land. And I'm surprised at the choice. She had two of these in, and she even caps it with a front somersault out. She really tested the knee there. And there's the second double twist. I think that knee's on the road to recovery, Barry.
Would it be a mark to set the others going? Well, we wait to see. She seems happy about it. There's the leader, Sidivash. Shushanova now in second place. Boginskaya in third. Dobre starting in seventh. Here's the Soviet girl to have a double challenge from Romania. Leading American girl at the back, Phoebe Mills. And she's a bit disappointed as she looks towards the scoreboard. 9.85 and one or two whistles. But she takes it very well indeed, but not the sort of score that she needed. Pity. She's in fact down in eighth position. Dagmar Kirsten in front. Sidivash leads from Shushanova second, Boginskaya third, after the first rotation, but so unbelievably tight.
And we'll just leave the gymnastics for a moment to give
And it's so close at the top that I still believe Shishinova's going to stay with the title, but she's going to be pushed all the way. She cannot afford to make one extra little step forward on any of the landings. It's that close. But I'm quite impressed. I've been quite impressed over the past few competitions with the Americans, because they really were, I think, in contention for the bronze medal. And I think they were unfairly kind of pushed out. We knew about the deduction that they had taken off of them. And we found out that the person that deducted it was the jury, the head of the judging, who happened to be East German. And it was Germany that ended up in third position. Because they're only...
Sounds a bit political to me.
Yeah, well, Yuri Titov, who is the president of the Gymnastics Association internationally, actually admitted that he thought it was very severe and a politically motivated decision.
Ooh.
So it's quite hairy, but they're thinking of abolishing that rule now. And that's what it was happened to. It just happened to be one of the team reserves of the American girls standing right on the edge of the podium. And she said it is a rule that there are no other gymnasts allowed on the podium. But it was quite...
In the women's individual competition, we'll return to Fenner and Barry Davis.
Well, the anthem we've heard so far in the gymnastics hall has been that of the Soviet Union. Winners of both the team competitions. Are we to hear it for a third time today, or will, through Daniela Sidibas, it be the anthem of Romania? There are two contesting perhaps the bronze medal, Potarac of Romania, Boginskaya of the Soviet Union. The main contenders have moved from the bars to the beam. It's Phoebe Mills of the United States. She's gone to the bars, where Boginskaya will be the first to perform. Interesting, looking through the development of the competition, Shishinova and Sidibas in the same group, starting where Sidibas has scored the better, two tens, now three tens. She got a ten on it on the bars to Shishinova's one. On the beam, Sidibas has also recorded 110. Then after that, we go to the floor where they both had a ten, and they end up with the vault where Shishinova has had two tens. Interesting balance, Mitch Fenner.
Very interesting. And the gymnast who works in the Olympic order will have the advantage here. That is, whoever starts on vault will get the cleanest competition. Young lady on vault now, Brandi Johnson from the United States. Yuchenko full twist. Slightly out of line. Clean and powerful in flight. Spinning round for that twist. There's the cartwheel. There's the backflip. And there is the full twisting straight somersault. Slight break in the body line. But look at the distance she travelled from that horse. 9.8 for Brandi Johnson. But one vault to come. Can she improve on it? I think if you open with a 9.8, it's a signal to pull out your most difficult vault. That is, of course, if she's got another one in the pipeline. We'll soon see.
Competitions, of course, going on four pieces of apparatus. Brandi Johnson continuing on the vault, looking as though she might do rather better on the second vault. Certainly they think so on the American team. Started with the 9.8.
Well, this was indeed a much more difficult vault. We're not going to see it, but it was a queer vault, which was a handspring half turn. Boginskaya from the Soviet Union on bars.